So you guys ready for the mailbag this week?
Yo, what up? Boom.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's start. Let's see what type of see what the schmucks are asking this week. The first one is from Enrique Martinez, and the subject is question. What's up, guys? What is your guys' opinion on WWE never using EC3 as the big star he was and still is when he was in Impact? I really think he would have had great matches with guys like Orton, Cena, Mysterio, and even Lesnar. Just curious what you guys think. And Enrique from Austin, Minnesota. I mean, whenever people ask me this stuff like this, I'm like, guys, if Vince McMahon does not like you, you're not going to get used. Yeah. For whatever reason, Vince did not see anything in this guy, and they just did not use him. And that's I don't know what else to say, you know?
And they didn't see anything in him the first time when he was Derek Bateman, and now he's coming back as EC3, which stood for Ethan Carter, Dixie Carter. It's referencing another promotion. That's already two strikes against him, I think.
Who's this guy? You heard this guy, I guess the talent guy. This guy's name is Canyon. Have you ever heard about this guy?
Yeah, I've met him before.
You've met him?
Yeah, I went because I bumped into him when I would go to PWG. He'd be there with Steve Regal.
I'm gonna be honest. All right. They hire a lot of guys, right? And I can tell right off the bat that they hire a lot of guys that I know Vince McMahon is not going to like. And I'm like, it's just weird. It's like, I wonder why these guys keep hiring these guys, and then they try them out in front of Vince, and they just never use them. And it's like, you have a pretty good catalog of the type of wrestlers that Vince McMahon likes. And it's like, they keep hiring guys they never use, and I'm like, you want to ask? I'd like to pick that guy's brain.
The only thing that Vince couldn't like about EC3 is maybe that he wasn't as tall as he likes his stars to be, but he had everything else, the look, the physique, you know, he could work, he could talk. But wait a minute. But here's the thing I don't understand is, why are you hiring people that, like you say, either Vince is not going to like or you're not going to push? You know what I'm saying? And when I saw EC3 get there, the first thing I thought was, if they don't push him right off the bat, he's going to get lost because there is so much talent. Remember you were asking me about Hijo de Fantasma?
Mm-hmm.
Like, he had called me the other day and he was like, man, why are they hiring so many guys? This is before they cut everybody.
Right.
And I was like, bro, because Vince doesn't want anybody to go anywhere, but Vince is going to learn you can't hire everybody. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And that's what happened. He just has this humongous talent glut.
Right.
You know?
And he just looks at guys and everything. But it's true.
It wasn't as bad for us in ECW because and WCW because at least we were used, but we were almost in the same position in a way because we knew there was a glass ceiling. We weren't going to pass that, you know?
Well, just let me tell you this too. This is interesting because you heard the stories about how Vince McMahon said he looked at Rey Mysterio and said, that guy will never be our champion, right? He'll never be. And he's a 3-time champion. Okay. Right. And you watch the way Ray works. You know, Ray's a little bit different than this new wave of high spot guys because Ray is way better at the details than these guys. And he throws good punches. He looks tough, and he's just, you know, he doesn't do as crazy.
And he comes from an era of great workers,
right?
Too.
So
he was
like,
working with them. And here's the other thing, bro, that will surprise you, Glenn. I don't know if I've told you this before, but not only that, bro, there was a time when he had a meeting. And he had asked everybody in the meeting what they thought if he should put the belt on Rey Mysterio. Everybody wanted them to put the belt on Rey Mysterio. And Vince was still against it. Okay. Yeah. So he gave the belt to Mysterio and he said, this is the day he's going to lose it. And bro, and this is something I'll never understand. It was almost like to prove a point. He made sure that from the time he won that belt to the time he dropped it, he lost, if you ever go back and look, he lost just about every non-title match that he was in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he buried him. He would come to San Diego, and he would lose in San Diego.
Yeah, remember that? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you came to me with a show once, I think, right?
Yeah, with you. Then we went backstage. Yeah. It was a tag match, and they lost.
Yeah.
But it's like, I would have thought that Vince would have liked EC3 because he looks great.
Right.
You know, he can talk. I don't know. Maybe just some of these, you know, maybe the writers there are so bad. And they, like, they'll have to do a spot. And they'll write him some stuff. And they'll write the guy some shitty shit. And Vince will hear that promo and just never forget it. And just be like, this guy. And just, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I don't know, man. They got a lot of really structural problems in the way they hire talent and produce talent. And it's like, it's running under the premise that, like, you know, it's, you still got to impress the old man. Yeah. And it's like, I can tell some of these guys they hire is like, these guys are not going to impress the old man. and they don't. And then nothing happens to them and stuff. And, you know, it's just, it's very weird because EC3, at the very least, should have been like, he's getting older, but like the Randy Orton spot. Yeah. Very basic worker, doesn't do a whole lot of stuff, looks great. His matches are, they're not five stars, but they're not one star. They're you know, 2.5 to 3.5 star matches, very solid. And like, they just never did anything with him. You know,
yeah, it's my thing would have been, all right. Maybe Vince doesn't see anything in him. Let's give him 1.5 years to get over. And if he doesn't get over in 1.5 years, you get rid of him.
But that guy looks the part. Like, you want guys in your show to look like that.
Hey,
it's,
you're crazy, preaching, you know? To the choir. You know, I think they could have done something to get him over, but they never gave him a chance. So he might have heat too.
Or it might have heat too, but or maybe they gave him some bad stuff and Vince just never, like, you know, just looks at that. So.